गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्लास एक्स मोशन चैप्टर एंड पर्टिकुलरली इन दिस सेक्शन इन दिस चैप्टर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डेरिवेशन ऑफ इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन बाय ग्राफिकल मेथड. सो इन क्लास 9x आर ix इट इज गिवन दैट थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट इक्वेशंस आर देयर एंड आई कैन से दीज इक्वेशन शुड बी डिराइव्ड बाय ग्राफिकल मेथड नॉट बाई मैथमेटिकल मेथड. सो हाउ दिस इक्वेशंस आर डिराइव्ड, लेट अस सी. यू नो दैट दिस इज ए वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ एंड एक्स एक्सिस टाइम इज टेकन एंड इन वाई एक्सिस वेलोसिटी इज टेकन एंड बॉडी इज हियर यूनिफॉर्म मोशन यूनिफॉर्मली एक्सेलरेट बॉडी. सो सी हियर एंड आफ्टर this is your initial velocity and after time t it attained a velocity final velocity v and it acquired the final velocity v. So in this figure we are just going to find the slope of the figure, the area covered by, in order to find the acceleration of the body or acceleration of the object we have to find the slope of this this figure. And again at the same time we are also going to calculate the area covered by the figure, area covered by the this slope by the body by which you can get the distance traveled or distance covered by the body. Let us see the equations. See what are these equations. Number one, the first equation is that v is equal to u plus at and the second equation is that s is equal to ut plus half at square and the third equation is v square minus u square is equal to 2s. Friends, you see there are three equations. One is v is equal to u plus at and the second equation is s is equal to ut plus half at square and the third equation is v square minus u square is equal to 2s. So see friends, from the first equation it is confirmed that if the first equation gives a relationship between v final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and time, and the second equation gives a relationship with the distance covered by the body, initial velocity, time and acceleration, and the third equation it gives a relationship between final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and distance covered by the body. Let us see what happens. In order to find v is equal to u plus at we have to find the slope of this figure, and in case of finding distance we have to calculate the area covered by the body or area covered this figure. Let us see. So friends, in order to find the first equation v is equal to u plus at, as I have told earlier, we have to find the slope of this figure covered by the body. So it means we are going to calculate acceleration is equal to bc by ac. bc by ac means bc, this is a right angle triangle, so we need to find the acceleration. We have to find the BC, ratio for BC plus AC. So acceleration can write A. So BC can be written, BC can be written BD minus CD. So BD minus CD by AC. But we know that BD minus CD, BD is V, CD is equal to U, so V minus U. So V minus U by AC, AC is 0T because it is parallel to the time axis. So A is equal to AC is equal to T. You can write here T. Now cross multiplication AT equal to V minus U. So V equal to U plus AT. This is the friends first equation of motion derived. Again speaking, acceleration can be calculated by deriving BC by AC. But BC can be written BD minus CD. BD minus CD. Again AC, this is your AC. So BD minus CD by SC, BD minus BC minus CD is equal to V minus U by T. So T is equal to V minus U. So V is equal to AT. U plus AT. Let us come to the second equation. So friends, as I have told you earlier, in order to find the second equation S is equal to ut plus v t square, we have to find the distance covered by the body in time t. The distance covered by the body in this area. So distance is equal to area covered by this figure, area covered by O A B D trapezium. So we can say distance covered by the body is equal to area of the trapezium OABD. Area of the trapezium OABD. Area, again speaking, distance covered by the body can be calculated by calculating the area covered by the body. That is OABD. So we can write. So this area of this figure can be calculated by the area of this rectangle plus area of the triangle. So area of this trapezium OABD can be split in two parts. So area of this rectangle plus area of this triangle. So we can write. So A is equal to what we are getting, area of rectangle OACD plus area of triangle ABC. So by putting the values, what we are getting, the area of this rectangle is breadth into length, so OA into AC, OA into AC plus half. Area of this triangle is half BC into AC, so we can write half AC into BC. So let us find now S is equal to what happens, OA is equal to U, AC equal to T, so U into T plus half AC into T into BC, B minus U equal to UT plus half T into. So in case of B minus U, we can write B, we know that, friends, we know that B, we know that B minus U, instead of V minus U equal to, we can write AT, because we know that V minus U by A equal to T. So this gives rise to V minus U equal to AT. So we are writing here. So what happens? UT plus half AT square. This is your S. This is the second equation of motion. Okay, friends. Let us come to third equation of motion. V square minus U square is equal to 2as. So in order to find the, again, in order to find the derive the third equation, V square minus U square is equal to 2as, we have to calculate the distance of this figure. Again, the distance covered by this body is equal to, again, this area of this figure, trapezium OABD. So distance covered by the body equal to area of trapezium OABD. So A is equal to area of trapezium sum of parallel sides into perpendicular height. So area of formula of this trapezium is sum of parallel sides into perpendicular distance. So now we are going to write OA plus BD into perpendicular distance OD. So let us see what happens. Have OA U plus BD V into OD T. So see what happens. To have V plus U, can write it V plus U, but T, what is the value of T? We know that T is equal to V minus U by A. So we can write here V minus U by A. So T equal to V minus U by A. So putting this value, now see A plus B whole into A minus B, what is coming? B square minus U square by A. So here is so friends, what we get here, that implies A is equal to V square minus U square by 2A. By cross multiplying we can get 2A is equal to V square minus U square, that is V square minus U square is equal to 2As. This is the third equation of motion. So see, so by getting the acceleration, the distance covered by the body, we can derive these three equations of motion by this graphical method. So this is all about today's class. In the next class, next part of this video, we will discuss the next